Guys, I'm just here to have our morning talk and to give you the update of the current events that are taking place in California, Los Angeles County. As we spoke about our last video, where I said it got to get worse before it get better, some of the things that we spoke about in that video, some of the things that I have put out there in the universe, that was my conclusion, my theory from me watching things unfold about it's going to be chaotic. It's going to be another plan to implement another way to have us on lockdown. In Compton, California, civilian, I don't know what to call him, a man, a person, I'm trying to think of the right words to call him because to me it's a monster, went up to two police officers while they were sitting in the car, shot them both in the head. Nobody knows why. Nobody, we all assuming it's retaliation from those that feel that it was police brutality that was happening all over the world, but that's not the way to handle it. Okay, on top of that, they are conducting police reform. So what do you think the outcome is going to be? You got to choose your battles wisely. Killing another man is not going to solve the issues that we are having. That's the same thing that was happening with the gang violence. Bloods against Crips, where they was just killing each other. But the problem that we have is, I don't see how regular citizens is going to win against a police force. That just don't make sense. Not everybody has access to weapons. And if everybody do have access to weapons, who want to sit there and go against an officer? I know I don't. I'm not saying that we're supposed to fear man because we fear no man but God. But you got to be wise. You got to choose your battles wisely. That is not the way you want to go. A lot of more innocent people are going to be killed. For what? No, you know what I'm saying? Like, everybody hears the slogan about we don't know who's good, who's bad. But that's why you got to pray this spiritual battle with prayer to guide you in the right direction. Just like us, I feel I work with a lot of good people that's doing a lot of things wrong, because the devil is the man, the spirit of all manipulation, to have you doing things that you feel is right but when in reality is wrong. And the reason why I say that is because I do have people that I work with that I can feel their spirit. Some I can feel and be like, yeah, you just faking to be good, but you, yeah, I can feel your spirit. And if those of you know what I'm talking about, sometimes you can talk to somebody and feel something off, you don't know what it is. That's just your gut spirit telling you, like, don't believe nothing they say, that person's against you. Long story short. And so that's what I'm saying, we got to pray for spiritual guidance, because God guide me to have those spiritual connections where I can just talk to people, or I can sit there and have a dream of what's going to happen within my life. Okay, and so what do we do about it? Right now, I'm praying for God to give me the okay to speak up. And the reason why I say that is because I'm at the point of my life where I'm around anybody, I'm ready to tell them, like, you are doing wrong against me. Whatever they told you is a lie. Why do you feel you got a fault? I get harassed at work, you guys, and my patience is done. I get harassed. I get up to the bathroom, somebody follows me to the bathroom and just stands in the bathroom washing their hands for like 2 hours or doing their hair. I have to conduct work where we have papers in a different location. I get up to go get another piece of paper. Somebody has to follow me to go get a piece of paper. I go back to my room, somebody follows me to my room and actually picks up the papers that I picked up to see what papers I am getting. That's how bad my targeting is. Okay, if I bring in food, they want to know what kind of food it is. If I bring in a bag, somebody goes, oh, what you got in the bag? Like, that's how bad I'm being targeted. And my patience is low, and I'm asking God, give me permission to release in the right way to let them know, like, this is enough, okay? But back to the real world of what is happening. This is why I say we have to start unleashing pictures of these target individuals. Not target individuals, these stalkers that are stalking us, because people need to know when it's things unfold, you are doing wrong. Yes, you, with the picture. When, if you hop on my YouTube channel, as the numbers get big, thank you for the people that are subscribing, because the more subscribers you have, the more chance it'll get out there for others to view. Okay, I'm taking pictures of these people that's harassing me now, because it's time for the world to see who is against who, so that they can see their own self, so they can realize I am a stalker. Because I really think some people don't think they stalk you. I think they think they're protecting their community. Are you serious right now? I really think that's what they're doing, because it's like just every morning this lady kept coming and having her kids come and harass me, and then she will come and harass me, and I start treating her. I said, you know what? I was angry. Angry for what? They're the ones going down, okay? And so I got out the car, because she always stands there, act like she doesn't have a key to get in her complex. I don't know why. So I get out one day and say, let me open the gate for you. You shouldn't be standing out here like that by yourself with a hope, because she had like cups of coffee. And she was shocked, like, wow, thank you. And I said out loud, God said, love thy enemy, so she can hear me. I'm that type of person that you're going to target. I'm not going to have no filters, not going to bite no tongue. And then when she would have turned around and said, what you said, I would explain to her why I've classified her as an enemy. You out here harassing an innocent family member thinking that it's cute. Okay, I had to pause because you know they caused distraction. The man behind me almost slammed into me, you guys, so I had to swerve to the side. He was trying to catch up to me so bad. He gonna be one of the followers, because my spirit seen so, because when I was driving, something kept saying, look behind you, look behind you, look behind you. And as I'm looking behind me, he almost slammed in the back of me, because he was like reading something, I don't know, but God told me to look behind me, and I had to swerve to the side. That's why you see the camera swerve. Distractions. I just lost what I was saying. But anyway, let me tell you why I said expose them, because let me tell you what happened to me. We had went on a family trip to Disneyland, let's say 2018, I believe it was, to Disneyland, okay? I seen the lady that harasses me at my son's school. She actually works there. She's always the one that waits for me when I come. It don't matter if I'm late, because my son might have had an appointment, she's there. She's at Disneyland too, and she made it a point for my family and I to see her. She runs all the way across the park like she was waiting for us in the front. Hi, so my son named, hi, so and so, hi, so, what are you guys doing here? Boom. I should have exposed her then, took a picture, like, really? Out of all days, all of a sudden, we just here. And we didn't go on a regular day. It was, like, during the holiday, so we went through, like, a weekday, not a weekend. Boom. Okay, so now that's 2018. 2019, we go to California Disney, whole different park. We seen the same lady at California Disney. And once again, what did she do? Made it a point to let my kids know that she was there. I wasn't there that day. Okay? So then I dropped my son off at school that following Monday. She runs up to my car because her goal is to let it be known that I'm the one being targeted. Know that she was at Disneyland too. And she walks up to the car, put her hand in the car, head in the car, and says, oh my God, I seen your kids at California Disney. I said, you seen us at Disneyland. They must pay you a lot to follow me. And she got mad and walked away and shook her head. Because I don't care. And then let me tell you another incident. This man was fixing on my car. I go to Universal Studios. Saw the same man at Universal Studios. So that's why you take pictures, because those are not coincidence. Those are following. People are following you. And on top of the same man I saw fixing on my car, he didn't seem like he knew what he was doing. He seemed like he was implanted there as a stalker, because he didn't know how to run the own machines. He didn't know how to take a payment. He had to wait for another man to come take a payment. So he wasn't there to fix my car. He was there to either implement something, some tracking device or something on my car, and that's all he knew how to do. But then I seen the same man at Universal Studios. I went and got on the tram, and next thing you know, he jumps right behind me and sits behind me. Like, haha, it's me. So I took a picture of him that day when I said enough is enough. That's all I wanted to tell you guys. I got to get ready to clock in so I can't keep talking. But think about that. Everything's unfolding. We're about to have a war in California. On top of that, the sun is red. orange. I went outside, and guess what happened? I came back, I had a headache, a bad, bad headache. I had my face covering on, but not to the point where it was like covering my mouth, because I wasn't getting out the car. I was going through the drive-thru to get food. And my head started hurting all day. And after that, my vibrations was down. I felt so depressed after that. Then my sister comes home. Same thing happened to her. She said, my head is hurting. My head is hurting. Called my friend. She said, my head is hurting. My head is hurting. I'm looking on Facebook. This other man said, have you ever felt depressed, but you feel like you have everything? Like, he just bought a house, got a nice Mercedes. And he said, but I feel so depressed. All in this same week, you guys, when the sun was orange. So think about that.